in my classes right now, I'm using a flipped classroom approach. The whole idea really is to invert the classroom. We flip what we think about occurs in classes. We usually think lecture in class, individual practice and homework at home. And that model's had issues for years. So the idea of flipping is we're just going to turn that around. So now the lecture video is watched at home, and then they come back into class, and what would have been practice or homework or anything else gets done in class. Some of the great benefits to the flipped classroom is that my students can come to class, they've had some idea of what the material is about by watching the videos prior to the class, and when they come in here, they are able to work with one another, they are able to ask me questions. It gives them really the opportunity to get the help when they need it and where they need it. The way that I'm trying to measure in my research the idea of any influence of the flipped classroom is I'm looking at two aspects. I'm looking at math anxiety and I'm looking at math achievement. And what I've done is I've actually got three sections of my Math 111 class, which is the first class that the elementary education students have to take in the Mathematics series. And we'll go through the semester, one class using my flipped videos, one class using the Khan Academy videos, and one class that is using lecture within the class. And so what I'm doing is I'm having a pretest that measures their math anxiety and an achievement test from the Praxis 1 scores, because the Praxis 1 is a test these students have to pass and a lot of them struggle with in mathematics. At the end of the semester, they'll take the math anxiety surveys again, and then they'll take the achievement test as part of their final exam again, so that we can look and see, is there any change from the beginning of the semester to the end of the semester? And that way it's trying to help limit any other factors that may be going on within the semester or what they came into the class with. I think the idea of looking at our instructional practices is important, no matter how well we think it's going, because there's always things we can learn from what we've done, reflect on that, and think about how can we improve it for the student population that we have now.